I'm not ashamed to admit it, I am a big heat press nerd. And if you're like me, you've probably wondered what goes inside making a heat press. So what we're gonna do is take this perfectly good heat press and show you what's inside. So we're gonna go piece by piece through the complete anatomy of a heat press, showing you why quality parts are very important and can actually make or break your business, and why a Heat Press Nation machine is definitely worth the investment. We're also gonna be comparing our Signature Series heat press with a budget heat press we found online. When developing and manufacturing these heat presses, we don't go into that process with the intention of building the cheapest machine possible. This is especially true when it comes to the heating element. This heating element is the heart of your heat press. Literally every other piece of this machine works together to support the function of the heating element. This is the piece that applies the heat and the pressure to your garment. So it's something that you definitely want to be made with the best quality possible. Now, as we remove the cover, we're gonna see a thick layer of insulation. And this is actually very important because it's gonna help to retain heat on the heating element. Now, that's a big deal because the more heat we can retain, the more energy we're gonna save and the less rebound time it's gonna have in between presses. Now, I'm revealing here, this is the money. This is really, again, the heart of your heat press. So we'll pull this back a little bit further, actually. So as you can see, this is where the lead wires connect to the heating element. This is where the electric energy is converted into heat energy. And these coils run around the perimeter right here, and they actually coil completely through the surface of the machine. Now, this coil runs through our cast aluminum. This is a solid heating element. It's thick, it's heavy, and this is what gets you that nice, even heat distribution throughout the plate. So we're gonna go ahead and put this back here. There we go. Now on the heating surface of your heating element, we'll try to flip this over carefully. Rather than using a sprayed on nonstick coating, like a lot of other bargain presses, we have an embedded nonstick coating, which is kind of like built into the surface of the heating element, which makes it a lot more resistant to chipping and scratching away of that nonstick layer. Now you'll see on the budget press, we don't have nearly as much insulation. We're also seeing that this is a much thinner heating element. In fact, when we bring it over to the scale, our bargain heat press heating element is coming in at just over 7.5 pounds. When we weigh our Signature Series heating element, we're seeing that it's coming in at almost double, right around 15 pounds. Now this is very important because this means that our thicker, beefier Signature Series heating element is gonna give you much more accurate and even heat distribution throughout the entire surface. It's also gonna take less time to rebound in between heat presses and virtually eliminates cold spots. All right, let's go ahead and talk about the skeleton of our heat press, which is the frame and the lever mechanism. Now every structural component of your heat press has been either cut, welded, or cast at our factory. Now this allows us to have complete quality control over everything. And as you can see, this thing is beefy. This is our frame, and this is actually the only part that we will not replace. So it's kind of like the frame or the chassis of your car. In the odd event that this were to get damaged, it's probably best to just replace the whole thing. That being said, this thing is so heavy duty, I don't believe we've ever had to replace one. Now this here is of course part of the lever mechanism. This is the part you're probably more familiar with. Now, both of these actually work together, and these have to be built especially strong. This lever is actually where the transfer of energy comes of you raising and lowering the lower platen and transferring that pressure energy onto your heat press. Another really well thought out part to this heat press are the joints right here that receive the most action and stress. They're actually outfitted with ball bearings to make the action super smooth and reduce friction. Now, one more thing I do want to know in our comparison with our HPN presses versus the bargain presses is just going to be the sheer weight of these things. There are so much more raw materials that go into the production and the build of our Signature Series machine, and it's really apparent when you weigh them. This smaller budget 15 by 15 inch press comes in at a whole 29 pounds, which yes, it's very light, but also you can kind of feel it. It's kind of flimsy. Now, let's contrast that with our Signature Series heat press comes in at a whole 77 pounds, which is really a reflection of how beefy this thing has been built. We can't afford to skimp out on parts. Honestly, I don't know how other manufacturers do it. At HeatPress Nation, most of our internal components are UL certified, which is great for quality. That way you can have the assurance that your machine has quality both inside and out. So let's talk about these parts. Honestly, I could pick up anything here. Right here, we have our transformer, which is responsible for converting electrical energy. We have our relay, all these top quality parts. Some of my key favorites here. This is gonna be an electromagnet that controls the auto open. So on an auto open clamshell machine, when the handle is lowered, there's a metal plate that locks onto this magnet. So this is a very strong electromagnet that holds the machine shut. And when the timer reaches zero, it gets a signal and releases that magnet so your machine can open up automatically on its own. Another really important gut here is our hydraulic shock. Now this is important because this is what helps to open the heat press on an auto open machine. And even if you don't have auto open, this is gonna give you a very smooth open and close action on your clamshell heat presses. Nothing wrong with spring powered machines, we carry some, but once you've tried a machine with a hydraulic open and close, you're not gonna wanna go back. It's so smooth. Now another feature on Signature Series and other models that a lot of people don't know about is the dual fuse. Now one day your fuse is gonna go out. That's what it's designed to do. Now two things can happen. One, when your fuse goes out, you're gonna turn your shop upside down trying to find your replacement. But on a Signature Series machine, it actually comes with a secondary fuse built in. So all you do, you open up the back, move two wires, close it up, and you're back in business in minutes. It's a lot better than having to find a lost fuse or go to the electronics store and buy a replacement. And again, that's just another way that your Signature Series has your production in mind. Now, if this is the heart of the heat press, then this right here is the brain. This is the digital controller, some might call it a computer gauge, and this is what controls the heat energy that goes into your heating element. This does a few things, actually. It receives temperature data from the heating element and then determines how much electric energy to send back to it to keep it at your set temperature. Now, of course, it's not plugged in right now, so I can't show you the controls, but one would use this to set how hot you want the machine in degrees and how much time you want on the automatic timer. This also sends the signal to the electromagnet on an auto open machine to release once the timer reaches zero. So this really, like your brain, does a lot to control all the functions of your heat press. And as if it wasn't doing enough already, it also keeps count of all of your presses so you know how many you've done in a certain set. So you know how many presses, kind of like an odometer, your heat press has done overall. Really helpful feature on this brain. All right, so I'm not sure what part of the body this corresponds to. I'm gonna go ahead and call it the backbone just because it's so important and because it supports what you're doing. So this is the lower platen here and it's partially assembled. As you can see here, we have this nice, it's kind of brushed, kind of unfinished here. This is the plate that supports everything. So your t-shirts go on here, your sublimation blanks go on here, everything goes on here. Now, because you don't want a metal against metal surface when heat pressing, we have our silicone pad. Again, another key element to this lower platen. Now this silicone pad absorbs the pressure and helps distribute it evenly on your garments. It's a really big part of how we're able to get such fine distribution of pressure evenly and consistently throughout the entire surface. Now, also the lower platen is my absolute favorite feature on any heat press, bar none, and that's the slide-out drawer. Now, the slide-out drawer is available on select heat presses, including the Signature Series clamshells, and the way it works is it has this drawer-like mechanism that's attached to the lower platen. So what that does, it allows you, instead of having to reach in under the heating element to position your t-shirts and your transfers, instead the lower platen actually slides out towards you like a drawer. Now we're really into smooth action over here. You should never feel like you're struggling with your heat press. And that's why the slide out drawer actually uses joints like this with smooth ball bearings. It's that feel that you could really tell the difference between a quality press like a Signature Series and a cheaper press that may have skimped out on a part like this. Now let's compare the slide out action, which is really nice and smooth on our Signature Series heat press, compared to the rough and very not smooth action on this bargain heat press we found online. A really great feature that I love, which can be found on all of our Signature Pro models, is SurePressure. Now, the SurePressure gauge is really awesome for helping you keep track of your different pressure settings. So as you adjust the pressure on your machine, the number on this dial is going to change as well. And this is going to serve kind of like a bookmark. It's very helpful if your shop is constantly pressing different transfers that require different pressure settings and or different materials. You're going from t-shirts to thick hoodies to sweatpants to denim back to t-shirts. And you don't want to always be second guessing your pressure settings, or you have employees who may not have as much experience as you. Having the SurePressure system built into your machine, all you have to do is just keep a list of settings, and that way you can be locked into consistent pressure every time. Now, there are a lot of other parts here that serve a lot of different functions. For example, we have our transformer here. We have a solid state relay. We have these two pieces that both work with our auto open system. This is our contact plate for the electromagnet. And this is our emergency release. So that way you don't have to wait for the timer to reach zero before you can open up your heat press. There's lots of different wires and components and even a handful of nuts and bolts that aren't shown here on the table just because we didn't have room. But all of these are built with quality in mind. And on most of these internal components, we are UL certified. What that means is that the quality of the production of these components have reached a certain level to attain that UL certification, really giving you quality and assurance that what you have inside your machine is gonna work when you need it to. As you can see, we have a lot of parts here, all of them working in harmony to where you don't really notice a single part functioning. What you should be noticing is one heat press working perfectly every time you press. With quality built into every last piece, right down to the nuts and bolts, you could rest assured that your heat press is going to work when you need it to. And while we're talking about parts, I should let you know that we keep a full stock of replacement parts for all of our HPN brand heat presses here at our Southern California Service Center. And we don't expect these parts to break or malfunction because they're defective. But after 15 years in this business, we're all too aware that wear and tear is a very real factor for busy print shops. And that's why we offer a minimum 1-year warranty and free lifetime technical support on all HPN presses. I hope you've enjoyed this insight into the anatomy of a heat press and what makes it work. For more heat press content, be sure to subscribe to our channel and do me a favor, hit that like button while you're at it. You can view our complete selection of heat transfer equipment and supplies at heatpressnation.com. All right, well, let's go ahead and put this thing back together. Oh, that was easy. We'll see you in the next one.